How you doing? It's your girl Tasha coming to you guys straight out of West Hollywood, Los Angeles, California. I'm in the hotel room right now just chilling. Oh, just got back not too long ago from all the festivities here for the X Factor finale. Shout outs and congratulations to Melanie Amaro. Girl, you did it, all right? I was like this much in doubt. I really thought Chris was gonna get it just because his fans are crazy and are hardcore like that. But America, you guys must have definitely have been swayed by those performances from last night. Now, so let's get into it. I'm not sure what day it is that you guys are gonna be watching this, but today is the 23rd. Like I said, everything has just wrapped up here. West Hollywood really showed out tonight, and the X Factor was amazing. Like, I appreciate it so much more because I was like actually here. All right, so now just to remind you guys, I was on the Pepsi pre-show live, so if you missed it, no worries, in a few days it's going to be archived, and I'll definitely send out the links to that as well. You can always come back to this video, check the description bar below, and I'll have the link to that, okay? But anyway, if you guys follow me on Twitter, you know all day I was just tweeting non-stop about X Factor stuff. I tweeted all the way up until the point that my phone died, okay? So I kind of missed it. Once the show came on, I kind of had to stop tweeting because my phone was dead, and that was just, I just had to wait, you know? So I got to tweet a little bit though when the West Coast actually got to watch it and everything. But you guys, this was an amazing experience. I want to say thank you to everybody who is a part of the X Factor digital team for bringing me out. You guys did not have to do that. I mean, to think that all of this started off of a simple YouTube video, you know? And shout outs to you, Brendan, because he was the one who actually saw the video and was like, hey, let's have her on as the Skype fan of the week, because that's what they do every week on the pre-show. They have a Skype, well, they have a fan that they Skype them in and talk about the show. And, you know, for them to even say, we really liked you when you were on, you know, Skyped in, we want to fly you out. So, girl, they flew me out. I was amazing. I got my makeup did. I got your lashes. Yes. Get into it, girl. Get into it. My lipstick is gone, but still, I feel amazing and whatnot. It was just an awesome experience. Like, I'm kind of having a hard time finding the right words to describe what was going on. It was still surreal. I don't think I'm gonna really soak it all in until I actually get back home to North Carolina, but totally stoked and still geeked about being here. It was amazing. Although the show, we were at the CBS studios, you know, so this is where they tape The Price is Right, Bold and the Beautiful, Dancing with the Stars. American Idol is also taped here, as well as a few other shows that are taped here at the CBS studios. It was just, I don't know, it was just an amazing experience to be behind the scenes, to see, you know, things that you see on television. You kind of see how it really is set up. The red carpet, the press line, June Ambrose's trailer. That was totally awesome. I so wish I could have went inside. But you guys, if you watch the pre-show live that we did tonight, you guys do get to see June Ambrose. She is totally amazing. She's gorgeous. Out here, so I got some pictures that I want to show you guys. So Dan Levy is the one who him and Taryn are actually the hosts of the pre-show, but Taryn wasn't here this time. I'm not sure why, because I really wanted to meet her. But Jim Cantinelli was the other co-host that did the pre-show with us tonight, so he's awesome. Both Dan and Jim worked for MTV News and all that great stuff, so me and Dan got a little picture in, and he's awesome. He's just totally cute. Love his glasses. I had a great time. He's funny and stuff. So he definitely helped me, you know, to not be as nervous as I was during the show. Let's see. I got some more pictures here, you guys. Remember when I said, would it be too shady if I took a picture with Chris Renee? Well, it's not, because I got a picture with Chris, and he was so freaking awesome. Now, when he was eliminated, it was a total shock. We were in the, we were still in the tent studio for the pre-show. That's where we actually watch everything going down, because, girl, tickets to the show were gone. There was no way you're getting in there. Security was extra tight. What is this little twisty doing here? Okay, anyway, like I said, security was extra tight, so if girl, it just wasn't worth it trying. So I'm so glad we stayed in the pre-show tent and watched on one of the mini monitors that they have there. When Chris was announced as third place, it was a total shock. Everybody in the tent did that. Oh my goodness, because we really wasn't expecting it. Now, one thing that I wasn't expecting is a lot of people actually thought that Melanie was going to win prior to, you know, it being announced. I was the only one who was like, I think Chris is going to get it. Just because, you know, he made it to the finale, so I just figured he was probably going to take the whole thing because I didn't expect him to go that far. You know what I'm saying? Top three? Come on now. But he's a total sweetheart. Still, at the end of the day, I love him. You know, I may judge harshly about him, but I still, you know, he's still a cool dude in my book. Love his heart. You know, I'm glad and I praise God for his recovery and everything. So Chris is going to be fine. So yeah, he was totally awesome to take a picture with. And everything. And the thing about it is, these people, like, I actually saw Chris yesterday when I came in to LA after the show, because he was still on the press line in the red carpet, you know, doing the interview. And it stoked me then when I saw him, because I was like, oh my goodness. I was like, is that? I saw Josh. Josh was doing his interview. I was like, oh my God, is that Josh? And then right afterwards, I saw Chris. But, you know, I couldn't say anything then because they were doing their press interviews, you know, with the big people. So that was totally fun. Let's see, I have some more pictures here I can show you guys. Saw this lovely lady in the hallway backstage. So Miss Drew, I went up to her and I told her how happy I was that she got to meet Justin Bieber, because she was so freaking excited about that. Like, that was all real. None of that was scripted. She was totally, totally stoked to see Justin and have him, you know, just be all up on her for a moment there. And Justin, that was a really good move of you to let her sing that last line of the song, because I really thought you was gonna mess it up. Now, I'm a Justin Bieber fan, don't get me, but Justin, you were just doing the most with that Christmas song. I was like, it's a Christmas song, you ain't gotta make it that gangster, okay? I don't know why he be so extra? You ain't got to be extra, man. I mean, come on now, calm it down some. This dude and his friend who decided to get in on the picture as well, but totally awesome, Mr. Leroy Bell. And yes, he is as beautiful in person as he is on TV, okay? And his friend wasn't looking too bad either. That's why I'm not too mad that he snuck in on the picture. All right, so that was totally awesome, Leroy Bell, getting to see him. Glad that he was back on the show. That was awesome. Ladies, you may be a little jealous of this, some of you younger girls. Mr. Marcus Canty, he was awesome. I stopped him on his way, and he was like, sure, let's take a picture. So, got to take a picture with Mr. Marcus Canty as well. That was totally awesome. Let's see, I got some more here for you. I saw this lady standing in the corner. She was talking to people, and then, so when she finished talking, I was like, can I get a picture with you? She's like, sure. Miss Stacy Francis, who was rocking this dress. Now, this is not, she didn't wear this on the show. This dress that she has on here, you can't see it, which I'm kind of happy, because, girl, Stacy, don't wear that dress no more. That dress was too tight and too short. That you need to quit, all right? You need to stop it. You somebody's mama. That's all I'm really. You was somebody's mama. You don't need to be wearing that, girl. Stop this dude. He was talking to someone, and I was like, yo, I have to try to get a picture with him. And he was so freaking nice. I wasn't expecting that. Claude Kelly, come on now. Super producer, come on now. Vocal coach, all of that. I was like, Claude. After we took this picture, I said, Claude, I just want to tell you one thing. When you get back in the studio with Fantasia, y'all better freaking bring it. Tell her I said to bring it. And he was like, I got you. I love Fantasia. She's my girl. That's my heart. I love her. We are going to be working together again, and she will bring it. So he was totally nice. He actually talked to us for a couple moments after taking this picture, which I was totally unexpecting that. And so this dude running around like a kid in a candy store, I stopped him, even though I said he deserved a butt whooping. I told him, I said, look, I might be talking junk about you, but I still want to take a picture. So this Astro, he stopped. You guys make sure you get his mixtape that's getting ready to drop and everything. So I'm definitely going to download it. You know what I'm saying? I like Astro. He's cool. Picture. You're not really going to be seeing it, but this is afterwards, after the X Factor cleared out and everybody's there trying to clean up. Confetti was still all over the ground, but just to prove that I was there. And let me tell you something, the X Factor stage, that whole studio, it looks huge on TV, right? And you would think that thousands of people are there. Girl, the studio only holds about, like, I think it's over 600. So 600 audience members can be there. But it's so small. The stage is not big at all. Like, it's not. It's small. But the thing about it is I like it because it's very intimate and it's so amazing. I think it would just be an amazing feeling to be on that stage performing and to have people so close to you. No wonder people cried and it was so emotional and all that stuff. All that energy flowing around like that, that's a totally amazing thing. So I was shocked to see, you know, how small and how intimate and how close the studio actually was when they taped it. Let me tell you. So going to the stage, right, because they wanted to show me the stage. Now, my contact for this whole entire thing was Michael. And Michael, hey boo, how you doing? He was so embarrassed. He took me. He was like, I want you to see the set and everything. Why, when this is my true moment of star struckness, we're walking in, and as soon as we're walking in, guess who's coming? None other than freaking Paula Abdul. And I don't know why. I guess maybe because I wasn't expecting anybody to be there. Just, you know, the cleanup crew. Which, because they were all back there working. They were tearing everything down. Girl, they didn't waste no time. The cleanup crew was getting it in. Okay? All right. So, you know, we snuck back in there. And, oh my God, Paula Abdul is coming out. And I stopped. And she's like right in front of me. And I think I either said, Paula. Or I said, hey Paula. I said one of those, and she stopped and she looked and she's like, hey darling. She reached out and she like rubbed my cheek. Oh my freaking God. And sitting here thinking about it, Paula Abdul, you don't know me, girl. What is you doing? Girl, you better go ahead with your bad self. She looked amazing. She's so teeny tiny. And just for her, like, she just stopped and she was like, hey, how you doing? Are you doing all right? Good. And then I was like, yeah, I'm doing good. I love you. You're looking good. She was like, well, thank you. And then she just walked on. I can't explain it. That was my moment of starstruckness. Freaking Nicole Scherzinger. Oh, girl, she is fierce, okay? That girl, she's fine. Yes, I know I'm a female, but that is one fine woman, okay? She walked past me like on three separate occasions, okay? I was too nervous to stop her because even though she walked past me, like, she was like, I could blow it, like, I could touch her, reach out and touch her. That's how close she was. But she seemed so sweet and so nice and so humble. She wasn't acting like a celebrity. She really wasn't. I mean, she was running back and forth, talking to different people, doing, you know, her thing or whatnot, which is why I didn't stop her at any point. Of course, she had, you know, a security guard with her, you know, whatnot. But it wasn't like she was untouchable, you know. If I would have said something, I'm pretty sure she would have stopped and we could have taken a picture. But I was just kind of like, you know, I don't want to be in the way. I don't want to, you know, she's on her way to do something. Nicole was looking fierce, though. I like the dress that she was wearing, too. I didn't get to see Simon Cowell. That would have been so awesome if I would have saw Simon. Or L.A. Reid. So I don't know where the boys were. But yeah, Paula Abdul. Oh, that was freaking amazing just to run into her like that. And for her to like stop and acknowledge me, because she could have just kept walking on. She really could have. But, I stopped. She stopped. It was amazing. Get it? So after the show, you know, the contestants have to go do their press interviews and everything. So the winner, Miss Melanie Amaro, came to the pre-show studio tent, and she did an interview there. I got to sit in and watch her interview. Y'all, she was definitely stoked and amazed by this win. When she came in, we were still actually watching the X Factor because, you know, it was just now showing here on the West Coast. So when she came in, she was just being totally funny. She was like, oh, you guys are watching now. Who is that chick? Oh, she looks, look at her face. She's looking ugly and all this stuff. But Melanie is totally amazing. She's so freaking humble. After she finished her interview, I went up, asked her for a picture. She was like, sure, we can take a picture. She had on some fierce heels, you guys, so she's really not that tall. She is taller than me, though, I will give you that. So maybe take off. I don't know. They probably could have been 6-inch heels that she was wearing, because them things was looking, they were hot. All right, she was like, my feet are crazy hurting. So she was putting on her shoes when I was getting ready to take the picture. And I was like, here, you just, you know, lean on me so you won't fall. She's like, girl, I fall all the time in these heels and stuff like that that they've been giving her to wear. So we took the picture, and then afterwards I told her I was Team Melanie the whole entire time. So happy for her. And she was like, thank you so much, I really appreciate it. She was like, you know what, you are rocking that purple, that looks good. And she like gave me some dap and everything. So totally humble and awesome. I loved it. I just had a great time. Season one of The X Factor turned out to be pretty good, you know. I had my doubts in the beginning, but actually being here now, and I was telling Michael this, I really appreciate the show a lot more because I got to see, you know, some of the stuff that was going on behind the scenes. Like, you know, I knew about the Justin Bieber, Stevie Wonder thing, you know, when I got here this morning, and everybody was talking about it and how, you know, it was an odd pairing, but it was going to be a really good performance. I got to watch 50 Cent and Astro rehearse. I got to see the top 12 rehearse. They're on the Edge of Glory. Performance that they did, and that really turned out really good too, especially with the lighting and everything, that, you know, just the whole big shebang. That was awesome. I really enjoyed it. You know, I was tweeting all day long, but I couldn't spill secrets about things that were happening, people that I was seeing, who was gonna actually be there. We knew Leona Lewis was gonna be there, so everybody was really stoked and happy about that as well. It's just kind, you know, it's kind of like a baby coming home when you have, you know, the winner of X Factor UK coming over and everything to do the X Factor USA. So, and y'all, we need to get into Leona because her performance was really good. Oh my goodness, she did really, 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 really good. I mean, for just, I enjoyed the performance. I don't know why we over here in America, the only song we like of hers is Bleeding Love, but I think we need to get into Leona a little bit more and support her more. She's doing fantastic over there in the UK. We need her to step her game up over here. Well, no, we need to step our game up for her. I'm getting tired. I think it's only 12:30 here, so I'm gonna go ahead and finally wash this hair makeup off. I don't want to take it off, I really don't, but can't keep it on and everything, so gonna go ahead and do that. Thank you guys so much for your love and your support and everything, and for everybody who was tweeting with me tonight. Thank you. I love you guys. God loves you. Jesus can save. Until next review, you guys, I will be talking to you soon. I got a gospel studio reviews coming up for you. All right, I love you guys. Take care. Bye. We'll